In my first video, I predicted the number of infections of corona, and so far it has become true. Then I predicted the death rate, and so far that has also become true. It's not any fortune telling or astrology, it's a pure medical science and combination of formula. I am Dr. Vishal. In this channel with me, we discuss maths of life and death, science of disease, economics of treatment, and your role in the whole process. Not just on corona, but every other disease that has ever occurred in this universe. Hello lovely YouTubers, how are you doing in lockdown? I hope you are making difference. And if not, there is a saying, if you think you are too small to make difference, try sleeping with mosquito. So my dear friends, you can make difference from wherever you are. And whenever you want, you just have to live a dream and should be willing to die for it. Recently, Dubai banned the testing kit alongside many other countries. It followed was Spain, India and all the European countries. Was it too late to ban RDT or not is another question. But the thing to note is what the excuses or explanation was. Dr. Anthony Thomas, the director of Diagnostic Division of Prime Hospital, told Gulf News, normally, our body produces antibodies in response to virus or bacteria when we are exposed to it. Usually, polymerase chain reaction PCR is taken through the nasal swab for early detection. In case of this rapid testing kits, the antibodies develop after 5 to 7 days or more, so it's not advisable for early detection, and the current kit is not reliable too. There are studies confirming that tests are widely inaccurate, giving false negative and positive results, offering an accuracy of just 30%. Well, that was harsh, because if we take this into account, only 3 out of 10 results that tested positive are actually true. Now, let us understand the mathematics of corona kit. It said that 2.6% of the population has been tested already around the globe, and that accounts for about 202 million of population, among which 5.6 million are total positive cases. Then by the fact that the kit reports only 40% of the positive cases, the actual positive cases is 14 million, not 5.6 million. Now, if you think this is worse, there is something more worse. Can you imagine how many healthy cases is labeled as corona positive and kept in isolation or for quarantine in big hospital with other corona positive cases? Around the world, it could be as many as 6.1 million of people mixed with actual corona positive cases. Only in Nepal, there is around 1200 cases that could have been falsely diagnosed with corona and forced to live in quarantine or some sort of isolation. Is that right or wrong? Where are we really going? It's a matter to discuss later. We can also discuss in comment below. On this note, let's move towards the today's topic. Perhaps the least well understood of concerns is the accuracy of RDT. So we discuss today about how does the testing kit of corona work? Is faulty reading conspiracy or a fault? What is wrong with testing? What is the efficacy or accuracy of the testing? What is the right method of testing? What are the alternatives of RDT? And what do you need to know if you are testing in home? Before we dive into it, there's a small request for all my audience. See the left top corner on the screen and please answer the poll. That is about what you'd like to see next from me. Now, our first question answered. How does corona's rapid testing kit work? If you have ever used pregnancy kit to diagnose pregnancy at home, you can relate. First, you take the kit, put some blood sample in it. When the sample is adequate, if there is any antibodies present, it will detect in the test and it will be interpreted as positive. Here I'd like to say something. If there is any medical students, doctors, nurse, paramedic students in need in detail but simple explanatory video on basis of which they can write in exam, please put below in comments, or if the likes increase more than 500, I'll make a separate descriptive video on how to test by corona kit in home and when. It seems the test is very simple, then where the thing actually went wrong? That leads to the second question. Is faulty reading conspiracy or a fault? Could China possibly do something with the kit? Maybe it could. But did it really do? The answer is no. It didn't do willingly. Didn't do any foul play either. However, it was in news that many pharmaceuticals companies didn't want the government to do contact tracing in different parts of the world. But that's not what we are discussing today. Yes. Unwillingly, what Chinese pharmaceutical company did is, they made antigen to detect antibody in human but forgot actually about SARS, influenza and MERS, the other family members of the virus. Most important thing is, they didn't formulate any guide to how, whom, who, how many times and when it could be used, because it was too early to know all about it. That is the mistake RDT making company did. Now let us understand this in simpler way. Actually, RDT, rapid diagnostic test, identifies the antibody in human blood. Namely, those antibodies are IgM and IgG. Now, IgM antibodies to SARS-CoV-2 are generally detected in blood after 5 to 7 days of initial infection begin. And IgG antibody to SARS-CoV-2 becomes detectable after 14 days following the infection. Positive results for both IgG and IgM would occur after infection and can be indicative of acute or recent infection. IgM antibodies may not be detected in first 5 to 7 days of infection. As shown in this graph and the table, it is clear that during window period only PCR is effective. The window period is when one doesn't have any symptoms. After the first symptoms appear, after at least 7 days of infection, both PCR and IgM is positive. Only during active phase of disease where there is lots of symptoms of corona, all three PCR, IgM, IgG, so-called rapid diagnostic tools are positive. Once the patient starts to heal or recovery phase, still RDT is positive. Even after the infection is over and it's a pass, RDT is still positive. So RDT doesn't say whether you have or not. It says whether you have or not. So on this basis, we are actually interpreting the results wrong. Now, that leads me to my next question. Why did it give false result? And what is important to understand if you are ordering a home testing kit? First and foremost, one should know when to do the test and when not to do the test. None of the tests are 100% accurate, but a major role constitutes in storage and stability of the kit. The kit should be stored in 2 to 30 degrees Celsius. It is stable up to 12 months. So you can't neither freeze it nor heat it over 30 degrees. The other thing is specimen collection. Though bronchoalveolar lavage up to 93% accurate, but it's very hard to take. The other accurate samples are sputum and nasal swab, among which nasal swab is one we are taking. And to remind you, actually blood has only 1% of the accuracy to provide while testing. Dr. Prokop says, when the nasal turbinate swab test is performed correctly by a medical personnel, the accuracy is similar to the tests of influenza. According to the CDC, the sensitivities of rapid diagnostic tests of influenza are approximately 50 to 70. That is what we are gaining now with corona, or when a trained, educated medical personnel performs it. Now, other grave problem is cross-reactivity. Now, cross-reactivity means when all other diseases are also diagnosed as corona and results was positive for corona or any other disease. Now, let's see. The kit shows cross-reactivity with many diseases. That means it recognizes all these mentioned diseases as corona. Our concern is not just all disease, but HIV, pneumonia, croup, bronchitis, influenza, common cold and urinary tract infections. These are some such diseases which we must have got at least once, not all but any one at least. Now if you have got any of the diseases ever in past, you have chance of getting corona positive by the RDT. Now that leads to my other question, what is wrong with testing? Actually, in the first 14 days, the maximum test accuracy is up to 73%, and by this table you can see the sensitivity of the test for first 15 days is not more than 70%, and after 15 days corona itself, or at least is evident without test, it has many symptoms to show within 15 days. So is this kit really working? question to us. I understand this is a very difficult topic. If you haven't understood so far, you can revise or at least pause the video and understand it, because what we are going to rather a little more difficult. Now we understand what is false positive and false negative and how it affects us. Actually, in a clinical sensitivity of PCR, polymerase chain reaction test ranges up to 66 to 80%. That means nearly 1 in 3 infected people who are tested will not show corona positive even if they are positive. Let's see in an example. Let's consider what happens if we test 10,000 people with this kit. Although WHO suggests recently as few as 3% of the global population has COVID-19 and many of them has recovered, this means that 3%, that is 9,700 of 10,000 tested, will not have had corona and only 300 people will have corona. Of the 300 people recovered, 93.8%, that is 281, will be correctly told that they have antibodies against the disease. Of the vast majority, 9,700 people who haven't had disease also will be told incorrectly, and around 4.4%, that is 427 people, will be incorrectly told that they had the disease, they have or have been recovered from this disease. So the actual proportion of correct positive result is 40% out of all positive cases. Now you can imagine what is really being done till now about corona and how far are we about testing and diagnosing corona. Now that means by far more people will receive false positive result than true positive result. Up to 60% of those released back into their home or company will risk infection to themselves and unknowingly spread the disease to others. This could generate a second wave of epidemic. If this is true, if the true prevalence of the disease in population is as low as 1%, then this figure could rise up to 80%. Can you even imagine? But the silver lining is, with just same RDT test done 2 times, the accuracy increases up to 93%. But are we doing it? Are our government doing it? That is again another question and another topic to discuss. We will do it in subsequent videos. Now, in short, false negative. False negative, while false positive are problem in wider community, hospitals can face an acute problem as a result of false negative too. False negative rate is up to 30%. That is up to 30 out of 100 person who are actually positive will be tested negative and sent to the community to spread the disease. Well, I leave up to my thoughtful, educated audience to think what to do and how to do it. Now I'll go to my next question. What is the right method of testing then? Well, the good news is some newer company is making PCR that claims better result, more than 90% of accuracy. But the problem is, will you get your hands on them or not? So with whatever we have, the first thing what we need to do is understand about the kit's maintenance, how to keep it, how to open it, when to do it, know the correct way of taking sample, and at least testing twice with any RDT in 14 days gap. By testing 2 times, as I said earlier, you will get as much as 93% of accurate results. The interpretation part needs to be understood, but this video will be lengthy if I include what I'll write down in comment box below, and I shall make a different video on this too. If possible, combine an RDT with PCR and the result will be 100%, or combining one RDT with one PCR result will also give an 100% accurate result. More better way is to stay home, get tested when you get symptoms. Lot better results will be yield. And what is alternative to RDT? Yes, the alternative to RDT is PCR again. But other alternatives are blood samples. In a corona case, if you see in blood samples, you will have certain values increase and certain values decrease from where you can diagnose it as corona positive or negative. Well, the increased value is neutrophil counts, lactate dehydrogenase, alanine, immunotransferase, or ALT. Other is AST, that is aspartate aspartate aminotransferase, total bilirubin, creatinine, cardiac marker, D-dimer, prothrombin time, and prolactin. And C-reactive protein is also higher, whereas the decreased values are lymphocyte count and albumin, that decreases. Thank you for your time. Please feel free to write if you have any query. Stay in home and stay safe. May God be with you always. Thank you very much.